Hello, and welcome to Lean Excel Solutions. In the last tutorial, we have seen how to prepare this Pareto chart in Excel. In this tutorial, we will learn to automate this. Like, if we change any value in this range, the chart will update automatically. The color of the bar will adjust accordingly for 80% and 20% contributors. Also, if we add or delete any entry here, it will be included in the chart automatically and at the correct position. So, in this case, you need not to sort data manually. Need not to change bar colors manually, and you can add or delete as many entries in it. In short, you can use it as a template. So, let's start with the input data only. Please note, if you are using Excel 2019 or older version, it will not work in your case, because I am going to use sort by function, which is available in the Office 365 subscription, and now in Excel 2021. Alright, first let's convert these columns to dynamic range, using offset function and name manager. Converting range to dynamic range, offset function, sort by function, etc., is already explained in earlier videos, so we will not discuss it much. If you wish to learn it in detail, you can watch it later. I will provide a link in the description. Let's use sort by function here, to sort it dynamically. Let's add the headings. For adding values, we will use index and match function. We can use VLOOKUP or XLOOKUP also, but I prefer index and match. Let's delete this now. Let's add cumulative total first, using SUMIF function. And now, let's convert it to percentage by dividing it by total sum. Alright, the range is converted in dynamic range now. If we add or delete any value here, it will automatically get updated with sorting and cumulative percentage here. Using this range, we can plot Pareto chart, but first let's add two columns first for 80% and 20% values. In this column, we will extract the values up to 80% only, using IF function. Let's copy the same formula for 20% and change the sign only. Let's select the range now and insert the chart. Change chart type for cumulative and format it a bit. Now, if we change any value in this range, the chart and column colors will be updated accordingly. But if we add any value, it will not change the graph range. Like here we can see, the last value from this range is not reflecting in the chart. This is because the chart range we selected is up to here only. Let's fix this issue using dynamic range for chart 2. But first, let's add the names for this columns also, as we did earlier. Now, let's update the chart range using the names we defined. So, the Pareto chart is fully dynamic now. If we made any changes in this range, it will get updated automatically in the chart. You just have to make sure that this column must have unique entries. Otherwise, it will give an error. You can format it better, as we did it in earlier tutorial, and use it as a template. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up, and subscribe to the channel, if you have not yet subscribed. Thank you for watching.